Welcome to Prime Studios. My name is John, and have you ever had this happen to you where you're working in your DaVinci Resolve timeline on a project? Here is my Nishika N8000 video, and you take a photo or video and you try and drag and drop it onto the timeline, but it's not letting you. You see a big circle with a line through it. It doesn't really matter what you do, nothing's working. So what the heck is going on here? How do you fix this? So the first thing you want to check is you want to go over to the left side of your timeline and look at what's called the destination control and track number, which is this V1, V2, A1, A2. And you want to make sure they are not grayed out. Each one has to be highlighted with a red-orange outline like this. Once you do that, you can then grab photos or video and then easily add them to your timeline. So what are these buttons and what do they do? Well, these are called the destination control and track number buttons, the V1, the V2, the A1, the A2. And the purpose of them is essentially you're telling the computer program, I want you to only add something to this specific track. Now, that doesn't really apply if I'm just dragging and dropping from the source window here. So if I take my old vlog clip here and I just drag and drop it, I can add it anywhere. So it's really meant more for when you're using keyboard shortcuts. So to start off, the keyboard shortcuts to actually change which track you're on is Control Shift and then up or down, or Control Alt and up or down for the audio. So I'm going to do Control Shift up to select video track 2, and then in my inspector or source viewer window here, I'm going to say set an endpoint for this clip, which you can do here, mark in, which is also the I button on the keyboard. And then I'm going to scrub through to say here, take a portrait of this police officer, and do out, or the O button will also work on the keyboard. Now, what I can do is I can take this and drag it over here to my actual video window. And you can see I have a couple different options. I can insert, overwrite, replace, fit to fill, place on top, append at end, and ripple overwrite. Now if I do it like this, let's say just a standard insert, it will then insert that clip onto the second video track. And then if I don't like it, I can hit Control Z and just undo what I did. If you want to continue with keyboard shortcuts, in other words, you've chosen your in and out points, you want this clip, you want it here on the playhead, which you can just move the playhead, and then you can say, okay, any button through F9, F10, F11, or F12 has different functions. F9 is insert, F10 is overwrite, F11 is replace, which is not working. There's nothing to replace, so it's not replacing it. So if I go down to this one and say F11 replace, then it replaces that clip. And then F12 is place on top. So right now my video one track is set. If I hit F12, it will then place that clip on top of the one I have selected. So these are essentially just faster keyboard shortcuts in order for you to edit faster. If you have any questions about DaVinci Resolve or you're having issues and you'd like me to maybe try and figure it out for you, let me know down in the comments below. Also, let me know if this solution works for you. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and thank you so much for watching.